Hello, my little friends. What are you doing today? Oh, well, greetings there, and welcome to my lab. I'm a scientist, and I study teeny tiny creatures. How tiny? So tiny that you can only see them with a microscope. These creatures are called microbes. Are you curious? Do you want to have a look? Let's zoom in.
Microbes are everywhere. They're in the soil, in the ground. They interact with plants and animals around us. They make the air we breathe and provide many of the nutrients we need to live. They are important and critical to how our planet lives. But sometimes they can turn nasty and cause disease. Some of these diseases are really important. For example, when these diseases start spreading around the world and killing important animals. These diseases spread when the microbes that causes them are passed to different environments or an animal enters a new location, bringing the microbe with them. Like this, they can travel far distances all around the planet, in water droplets, on grains of dust, on other animals like us or a pet, or the food we ship around the world. Once, in the new environment, the microbes can infect and kill vulnerable animals. Animals that are important for the environment they live in. This can be devastating for some ecosystems. One group that has been particularly affected is the frogs. Let's think about microbes. Do you think all microbes are germs and are harmful? What other things do microbes do for us? How can germs spread? Let's think about frog biology. Frogs are classified in the animal group amphibians. They have a spine down their backs. They are vertebrates like us. Humans are classified as mammals. Frogs have a very different life cycle and mode of reproduction compared to mammals. Frogs lay their eggs externally. The egg then develops into a tadpole that can swim around and feed in the water. As they feed, they get bigger and develop arms and legs. This is called a froglet. The froglet then loses its tail to become an adult frog that can then leave the water, breathe air, and find new places to feed and lay eggs. We call this developmental process metamorphosis.
Oh, I can't wait for my arms and legs to grow.
As scientists, we seek to come up with new ideas to explain what is happening in nature and then do experiments to test those ideas. We think that tadpoles, baby frogs, are particularly in danger from disease spreading around the world.
Hey, oh, this doctor says we're gonna get sick.
Well, Bill, I feel fit as a fiddle.
Did you know that the immune system, that system that fights off microbes that cause disease in the tadpole's body, is not fully functional until metamorphosis starts and the tadpole starts growing legs? This makes tadpoles particularly vulnerable to disease. My team has been investigating a newly detected microbe, a parasite, that looks like it is making tadpoles sick. It looks like this is a real problem for tadpoles in America, and we think that the parasite that is causing this disease is spreading. If the tadpole catches the infection, they become disorientated, tired, and begin to swell up. My team and I want you to help us track down this parasite and work with your teacher to see
if this parasite is already in your pond?
Can you help us? As scientists, we ask questions and use experiments to test our ideas. Our scientific question here is, are specific germs of tadpoles spreading across the UK?
You want to know how you can help us? We want to build a map recording evidence of the tadpole parasite in the UK. To do this, we need you to work with your parents and teachers and to take samples from different ponds. This is a mammoth task and it would be impossible for my team of scientists to accomplish. So we need your help and we want you to become part of our larger scientific team. The first step is to contact us and register to become a team member and tell us everything about the ponds and the frogs you see in there. Once you've done this, we send you a package with all the necessary scientific equipment that you will need during your fieldwork. Ask your parents and teachers to send us an email to contact@tadpoledoctor.co.uk. And please, it is very, very important that you do not do any fieldwork or fieldwork preparation near the ponds without the help of your teachers or parents. The package will include gloves of different sizes, disposable spatulas, our 15 ml sampling tube, disposable pipettes, one tube containing and preserving fluid, and the return box for posting. So let's start tracking down this parasite.
Woo! Woo!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Woo! Science! Yeah!
Even though the parasite is not dangerous for us, we need to be careful and carry gloves during sampling, as we don't want to help to spread the parasite. Remember, the parasite can travel on animals to new location. It can also travel on us. Therefore, we change our gloves each time we go to a new sampling location. So first, we put on a new pair of gloves. Ready? Perfect. Then you will find three spatulas and three empty sample tubes in the package. Let me see. Oh, here they are. You will need the spatula to take the sediment sample, and you need the sampling tube to store the sediment. The best chance of finding the parasite is to take the sample from an area close to where tadpoles often group or where the frogs lay their eggs. Please do not disturb the eggs, and remember, you must do this with the help of teachers or guardians. You will need the spatula to take the sediment sample and the sampling tube to store the sediment. Now, you have to be very careful. Don't lean too far over the edge of the pond. We don't want you to fall into the water. If the sampling location is too difficult to reach, ask your teacher for help. Now, take one spatula and fill the sediment into the sampling tube up to the 3 ml mark. You will see numbers on the sampling tube ranging from 1 to 15 ml that help you to estimate the right amount of sample. If there is no sediment you can sample, a water sample is as helpful. In that case, the spatula is obviously of not much help. In the package, we also packed these disposable pipettes that you can use to sample the water. As for the sediment sample, we fill the sampling tube up to the 3 ml mark. So now we have one example for a sediment sample and one example for a water sample. While we are looking for different sampling locations, we close the lid of the sampling tube and we dispose our gloves and put a new pair on. We must not help to spread the parasite. Once you have changed your gloves, you are ready to go and repeat the sampling procedure. Finished? Great, well done. Now, take your last clean pipette and add 12 ml of the preserving fluid into each of the sampling tubes, which helps to keep your sample fresh during the posting. The preserving fluid is not toxic, but please don't drink or touch it. Here it is. We open the lid of our sampling tube and we add 12 ml of preserving fluid into the tube. The reading of the tube will show 15 ml on the scale. This is because we add the sediment sample before up to the 3 milliliter mark. We close the lid of the tube tightly and we shake the sample for 10 seconds to be sure that the whole sample is well mixed. Great, you're almost done. Finally, put all the items, your sampling tube, and items for disposal like empty tubes, spatulas and pipettes, and the gloves into the sealable pouch labeled 95 kPa. Add the absorbent pad to the pouch and seal it. Please make sure that you keep the pouch with your samples and your waste upright at a dark and cold place, like your fridge, until you're ready to post it back to us. For posting, simply put the pouch into the postage paid box, seal it with a security seal, and post it back to us. Thank you very much for your help. Together, I'm sure we will track down the parasite. On tadpoledoctor.co.uk, you can keep track on all parasite records and tadpole infections. And please send us any pictures of the pond, tadpoles, and frog life cycles you create as part of this project, and we will add them to the website along with your results. Oh dear, looks like we have a parasite infection here. In case you see some dead tadpoles doing fieldwork, we have a manual on how to sample dead tadpoles on our website. And the kit provided includes all the equipment to allow for dead tadpole sampling.
Can you help us to detect the germ in pond water? This will allow us to map where these parasites are across the UK. If we know where the parasite is, we can understand how it is moving across the environment and plan to protect wild frogs. To get involved, see tadpoledoctor.co.uk.